To you, family, grace and joy to you. Welcome, welcome, welcome to Operation Good News, Fresno, California. We are glad that you are here with us on today. My name is Dr. Wilson, and of course, I'm excited to see you on the Lord's Day in the Lord's house, preparing and equipping yourselves for the work of the ministry.
Amen.
As you know, Operation Good News is a 24-month evangelism campaign that sister churches in the city of Fresno have embarked upon to reach the lost with the good news of Jesus Christ. At the end of our 24 months, we are endeavoring to do a citywide harvest festival at the Great Selling Arena. And so we are experiencing preaching and teaching God's word every week, equipping the saints for the work of the ministry, and praying for you each Tuesday night as you list the names of those lost in your families, your communities, on your jobs, so that we can see the Spirit of God draw them unto Himself. I'm happy today to bring this wonderful news. We want to thank the Rising Star Church for being here. Friendship Baptist Church is in the house this morning. Amen. New Beginnings
amen,
is in the house. And we have a preacher par excellence.
Amen.
He is a national evangelist, and I'm going to read his bio for you shortly. But as we come, it's our endeavor to have you to share this page right now. Would you go ahead and share this with a beloved friend to dial in and to watch this evangelism lecture today? He's coming to teach us how to do evangelism in the age of COVID-19. Oh my. What a powerful, powerful lecture. If this is one thing we've known and need, is how does the church reach the lost when you've been quarantined? Amen. What a time we're going to have. Well, who is this great teacher and evangelist today? He is none other than our brother, beloved, the great Dr. Manuel Scott. Amen. He's the first seminary-trained evangelist on a national scale coming out of the Black Baptist Church in North America. He's recently been appointed the official full-time evangelist of the National Baptist Convention of America. His ministry is endorsed by some of the greatest preachers known in the world today, including Dr. Manuel Scott Sr., who's in glory now, Dr. Ephraim Williams, Dr. E.V. Hill, in glory as well, Bishop Charles Blake, Bishop T. Larry Kirkland, and a host of great preachers, none other than our president, Dr. B.T. Lewis, here in the city of Fresno. Dr. Scott has conducted over 1,100 revivals and crusades, averaging 53 revivals a year, wherein some 20,000 people have come to the Lord. A big amen goes right there.
Amen.
He's the author of the book, The Quotable Manuel Scott Sr., Words from a Gospel Genius. And this book is a collection of nearly 500 quotes and 7 sermons spoken or written by his late great father, Dr. Manuel Scott Sr. Dr. Scott was the senior class president of Dorsey High School in Los Angeles and a freshman class president of Bishop College in Dallas, Texas. He's a graduate of UCLA, received his Master's of Divinity from Princeton Theological Seminary, and was accepted into the PhD program at Claremont School of Theology here in Southern California. He has written over 115 printed lectures, including such titles as I'm Too Blessed to Be Stressed, Preacher, Wait Your Turn, and What's Up? He wrote, Sister, Does Your Man Pass the Test? He wrote, What the Bible Has to Say About Worship and Praise? How to Inspire and Organize Youth in the Urban Church, and Church Evangelism According to Christ, to name a few. Dr. Scott believes that the gospel has the power to save, free, change, and heal anyone, regardless of race, creed, color, or denomination. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Fresno, we are in for a gigantic treat today as one of heaven's greatest teachers, evangelists, and Bible proclaimers comes to us with the word of the Lord. After this next selection, the next voice you'll hear will be that of our lecturer for the Operation Good News campaign today, Dr. Manuel Scott Jr. Hear ye him.
Can I tell y'all one more time, one more time? I said he saw the best in me. When everyone else around could only see the worst in me. I wish I had a witness tonight. All I need is one. Hey!
He saw the best in me.
When everyone else around me, yeah. Anybody have that testimony? When folk walked you off, said you would never make it, what did he see?
He saw the best in me.
When everyone else around me asked, and I am his. It doesn't matter what I did. He only sees me for who I am. Does anybody know that tonight? See, he is mine, and I am his. Said it doesn't matter what I did. See, he only sees me for who I am.
Shall we bow our heads in a word of prayer?
Yes.
Shall we bow our heads in a word of prayer? God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love,
yes,
and of a sound mind.
Yes.
Yes, God.
Trust in the Lord with all thine heart.
Yes.
Lean not unto thine own understanding.
Oh, yes.
In all of thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path.
Yes, yes.
It is again, our Father, my God, that we, your children, come, the most wondrous, comforting, and amazing name we know.
Oh, God.
And that is in the name of Jesus.
Yes, yes, yes.
We come in the name of Jesus.
Yes, in the name of Jesus.
Not in the name of Buddha.
No.
Not in the name of Confucius.
No.
Not in the name of Muhammad.
No, sir.
Not in the name of Allah.
No, sir.
Not in the name of Oprah.
Yes.
Certainly not in the name of Donald Trump.
Right, right.
We come in the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes, yes, God.
A name that is above every name.
Yes, sir. Mm.
Name at which every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess.
Yes, Lord.
That Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father.
Yes, sir.
Become his name saying, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for giving us such a beautiful day this day.
Thank you.
Thank you for last night's lying down.
Yes.
Thank you for having sent your holy angels who kept us.
Yes, Lord.
From all hurt, harm, and danger.
Yes, yes.
And then, God, you allowed us to rise early this morning and you clothed us in our right mind.
Thank you, Father, Lord.
For this, we say thank you.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord God, for this gathering this morning, for this great outreach ministry of New Beginnings Baptist Church under Dr. Angelos Wilson.
Yes, yes.
Thank you for this good news ministry.
Thank you, Lord.
Outreach and ministry.
Yes.
And mission effort.
Yes, Lord.
Continue, Lord God, to bless Dr. Angelos
please,
and this great church,
yes,
congregation,
yes,
for they're trying to do the work for you.
Yes, Lord.
In your name.
Yes, Lord.
We say thank you for our dear friend, coordinator, Dr. B.T. Lewis.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for his love and support.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for Pastor Battle.
Yes.
And the great work he's doing.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for every saint of God under my voice
thank
and
you,
those perhaps who are looking who may not even know the Lord at all.
Yes, Lord.
Now, God, today we ask that you would just have your way.
Have your way, yes, Lord.
Have your way.
Have your way, Lord.
The Bible says that your son Jesus came preaching and teaching.
And teaching.
Have your way.
Have your way.
We'll give you all the honor, praise, and glory.
Yes, Lord.
We're so mindful of those who are less fortunate than ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
And we ask even now that you forgive us for all of our sins.
Yes, Lord.
And then, Father, your servants must earnest request that you let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight.
Thyself.
O Lord, my strength and my redeemer.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Certainly we give all honor and praise and glory to God, our Father, who's also our Savior, through his darling Son, Jesus, our Christ. Certainly to our host pastor today,
God bless you, Angelos God.
Wilson,
love you, man.
Who introduced us in such an oceanic fashion.
Good to see you.
God be praised. Amen.
Home,
amen.
Yes,
I need to be paying him for that introduction.
Home,
maybe I'll take you on the road.
All right, God.
And your assignment will be just the introduction. I'll pay you well.
I'll take you.
Thank you. Thank you for it so much.
Amen.
Dr. B.T. Lewis, amen. Our coordinator. Citywide Revival, great friend, Pastor Battle.
Yes.
Good to see you and your good people. Amen. To all of these great evangelists who are here, preachers and lay people.
Yes.
Certainly to those of you who are watching us by way of social media, and to you, the saints of God.
Yes, sir.
Truly, this is a day that the Lord has made.
Uh-huh.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise be to God. Let me just check the house. How many of you here today are glad that you are alive?
Oh,
yes, sir.
Raise your right hand. Glad that you are alive.
Yes, sir.
And how many of you here today are glad that you are alive in Jesus?
Yes, sir.
Wave both hands at me like that and say, preacher.
Preacher.
Oh, brother preacher.
Oh, brother preacher.
I'm happy glad.
I'm happy glad.
That I'm alive.
That I'm alive.
In Jesus.
In Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Yes, sir.
For the pastors, Dr. Angelos, I've discovered that while a person can exist without God,
uh-huh,
one cannot really live
without
God.
No, sir. Man.
Jesus says, I'm come that he might have life.
Yes.
And that he might have it more
abundantly.
Yes, sir.
A person really doesn't know what living is all about until they met Jesus for themselves.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
God
be praised. Again, we're so happy to be here. Amen. Pastor Angelos and I have been talking about me coming to this place for some time. And he's been kind of an itinerant pastor, moving from one building to another.
Yeah.
But my God, God has blessed him with a beautiful spot here.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen. We thank God.
Amen.
In fact, that's right. Let's have Pastor Angelos stand. Give him a hand. Come on, my brother. Give him a hand.
Praise God.
Praise prayed for today. In fact, Pastor, come forward. I got a little something for you.
All right. Amen.
Amen. And thank you for the gift he gave me, a beautiful gift. I haven't looked inside yet. Amen. Uh-huh. And then he gave me an honorarium that I have in my pocket. What, and I'll look at that a little later. Uh-huh. Amen. But Dr. Angelos, I want to present this gift to you. Amen.
Amen.
As a token of my appreciation and affection and admiration. Please accept it in the spirit in which it is given.
Amen. God bless you, Brother Angelos. Love you, man. Thank you so much. Amen.
I think you're going to appreciate it. Give him another hand. Come on, give him another hand. I just have to thank Dr. D.T. Lewis for his love and his support of our ministry. Amen. I'm coming here to Fresno this time on his ticket. Say amen.
Amen.
I'm preaching for everybody, but I'm on his ticket. Say amen.
Yes,
amen. God be praised. And he's just a wonderful soul and a wonderful friend. Amen. I want him to stand. Give him a hand, those of us who are here. Thank you so much, Pastor. Thank you so much. Let me quickly say a word about the resources that we have right over here at the table. And of course, I'll be manning the table today. So important, brothers, please believe me, that you take advantage of the resources here.
Right.
Amen. Yeah. Praise be to God. Amen. You want to get these resources because they will be a great blessing to you. Yeah. The first resource I want to mention, amen, is my lecture that I have done on the virus. In fact, I'm teaching, and I'm teaching this all over the country, sometimes in church, sometimes by way of Zoom. It is entitled Vital Lessons from the Virus.
All right.
What God is saying to us.
Yes, sir.
Through this COVID-19 crisis. I deal with 12 issues, amen, I believe are being raised during this season.
Uh-huh.
The first issue is entitled A Season of Exposure.
All right.
Amen.
All right.
During this pandemic,
yeah,
as it battled everything and everybody,
yeah, my Lord,
are being exposed,
yes, sir,
for who they really are and for who they've always been.
My.
Then we have another issue in here entitled Social Distancing as a Metaphor.
My God.
We're told that in order to remain healthy, we need to keep distance from each other during the pandemic.
Yeah.
Well, Pastor Angelos, I maintain that even when the pandemic is over, there's still some people you need to keep your distance. I'm trying to help somebody. There's still some people you need to keep your distance. And then we have another section in here entitled When the Masks Come Off.
Oh my God.
You got to get it. Everybody,
yes,
get it. Amen. If you'd like to order it from our website, www.manuelscottjr.org, or contact the church and Pastor,
yes,
get in touch with me.
Yes, sir.
Also, praise be to God, because we're dealing with evangelism today, you want to pick up our two lecture set entitled The Evangelism Discipleship Package.
Yes, sir.
Two lectures that I've taught around the country, Church Evangelism According to Christ, and then Discipleship for the 21st Century.
All right.
These are resources, brethren, that will be a blessing to you. The last thing I'm going to mention is, in my humble estimation,
uh-huh,
the greatest book written on personal soul winning.
Yeah.
It is entitled The Golden Path,
my God,
to Successful Personal Soul Winning by Dr. John R. Rice. Oh, my God.
Huh.
What a fabulous book. Amen. And we, in our community, we haven't been apprised of this book, but I'm going to push it out. Amen. Because it is just fabulous.
Amen.
Amen. In fact, in my presentation today, I have several quotes from this very book. Mm-hmm. But you want to get it. The best book, in my humble estimation, written on personal soul evangelism.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Praise be to God. All right, let's move right into our lecture for today. Pastor D.T. Lewis mentioned to me, in terms of what Dr. Angelos Wilson was doing here relative to evangelism, and he said, Brother Preacher, maybe you ought to do something like doing evangelism in the age of COVID-19.
Yes, sir.
I said, that's exactly what I'm going to do.
Amen.
That's the exact title I'm going to use. So the title, I'm indebted to my friend, Pastor Lewis.
Yes.
All right? Praise be to God. We're going to open up. Everyone should have a lecture. If you do not have a lecture, raise your hand. If you do not have a lecture, all right, praise be to God. Here again, we're going to open up with quotations from John R. Rice's book, the golden path to successful personal soul winning. All right, his first quote says, "Thank God for the privilege of keeping a soul out of hell. A billion years and then a billion years and then a billion years more."
My God.
When you save a soul by way of your personal witnessing,
yes,
you're
sir.
Keeping them out of hell.
My God.
For billions and billions and billions of years. Amen.
Amen.
Here's a tremendous statement for every preacher and every teacher to understand. And every preacher ought to remember that he is not preaching to a crowd, but an individual.
Yeah.
Oh, you're talking about effective preaching.
Yes,
you
sir.
Keep that in mind.
Yes,
that you're preaching to individuals.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. A soul-winning pastor.
Uh-huh.
Makes a soul-winning church.
My God.
Starts with the leadership.
Yeah.
Starts
yeah.
with the leadership. Amen. And we commend Dr. Angelos and Dr. BT. Amen. Pastor Battle and others. Amen. Because they are leading the way. This is one of the greatest statements I've ever read relative to evangelism. God has given every Christian the key to somebody's heart.
My Lord.
He's given every Christian.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Choir member, deacon, trustee, praise team member. Amen. Just regular members.
Yeah.
Pastor, preacher. Amen.
Yeah, right.
He's given every member.
Every member.
The key.
Yes, sir.
To somebody's heart.
Yes, sir.
Now you have to understand that our keys are not the same.
Uh huh. Right.
But we all have a key.
Yeah.
Amen. All have a key.
Yeah.
Amen. We all have keys to somebody's heart.
Somebody's heart.
Somebody's going to listen to us. Amen. The person who may not listen to Dr. BT may listen to Dr. Angel.
Yes, sir.
The person who may not listen to Dr. Wilson may listen to Dr. Battle.
That's right.
He's given us all keys.
Yeah.
Amen. To somebody's heart.
That's beautiful.
The final quote is, if soul winning is the main purpose and concern of God, which it is, we may be sure that to hinder soul winning is Satan's chief object.
My.
What a job he's doing on the body today.
My God.
Evangelism is not even in the room.
Lord Jesus.
It's not even in the room.
Lord.
Evangelism.
Lord.
Amen. And that's because of Satan. All right, now, we're talking about during evangelism in the age of COVID-19 crisis. I just want to go over a few terms. Now, in my lecture on the virus, I mentioned many more terms than this. But here's some basic terms that you need to be aware of if you are not already. The first term is virus. Uh-huh. Somebody help me say virus.
Virus.
And that's from the Latin word that means venom. And it refers to tiny agents that can cause infectious diseases.
Yeah.
The next word, very interesting word, praise be to God. My wife kind of taught me this word before I looked it up. My wife, by profession, is a veterinarian.
Okay.
Say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. This term is zoonotic.
Okay.
Zoonotic. Help me say zoonotic.
Zoonotic.
Refers to a disease that is transferred from animals,
uh-huh.
bats,
yeah.
rats, mosquitoes, etc., to humans.
Ah.
The next word is quarantine.
Huh.
From the Latin word quarantina,
uh-huh.
meaning 40 days, somebody get me to say 40 days.
40 days.
And it is enforced, sometimes voluntary, confinement and restriction of individuals or groups of people to prevent them from spreading a contagious disease.
My Lord.
The next term is asymptomatic.
Asymptomatic.
Refers to not showing any signs that a disease is present in a person's body.
Wow.
The disease is present,
uh-huh.
but they're just not showing any signs.
Yeah.
And then the last term is pathogen.
Lord.
And that's an agent, bacterium, or virus that causes a disease.
Uh-huh.
All right, let's turn the page. Our next section, amen, very fundamental section, deals with really what is evangelism.
All right, y'all.
We get a term, really, what is evangelism?
Yes, sir.
All right. Evangelism, praise be to God, taken from John R. Rice, is getting an individual changed into becoming a child of God. That is evangelism.
My God.
Getting individuals changed into becoming a child of God.
Yeah.
Great East Indian doctor, D.T. Niles, has made one of the most classic statements of Angelus on evangelism. Listen to this. Evangelism is one better showing another better where to find some bread.
Yeah.
My God.
God.
That's good.
Showing one beggar.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. A beggar showing another beggar where to find some bread.
Yes, sir.
Evangelism is to present Christ in the power of the Holy Spirit, that people shall come to put their trust in God, to accept Him as their Savior, and serve Him as their King in the fellowship of His church.
Yes, sir.
The Archbishops of Canterbury. For our purposes today, evangelism may be understood as the process. Somebody help me say process.
Process.
By which the saved present the gospel to the unsaved.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Whereby the unsaved accept Christ as their what?
Personal Savior.
Personal Savior.
That's good, Doc.
This presentation of the gospel can take on many different forms. And brothers, let me say this, and to all of you great pastors who are here and are listening, amen. Brothers, if we try to come back from this pandemic with business as usual,
well,
the church is going to die.
Talk to us, Doc. Right.
I mean, he's going to be on his deathbed.
Talk to us.
We have to be more creative.
My God.
In our evangelism.
Yes, sir.
We have to be bold and white in our evangelism.
Yes, sir.
All right? This presentation of the gospel can take on many different forms. The gospel can be presented how? Individually.
Yes, sir.
All right? That's person to person witnessing. The gospel can be presented congregationally. All right?
Uh-huh.
Praise be to God. Mm-hmm. When a given congregation witnesses to the community in multiple creative ways, carnivals, parades, picnics, tent revivals, food and clothing giveaways, etc.
Uh-huh.
The gospel can be presented organizationally.
Yes, sir.
Billy Graham Crusades, Campus Crusade for Christ, Evangelism Explosion, what have you. The gospel can be presented, theatrically.
Oh, God.
In terms of plays, dramas, skits, musicals, readings, etc. Yeah. All right? The gospel can be presented homiletically.
Yeah.
Preaching specifically on evangelism.
Yeah.
The gospel can be presented didactically. Teaching specifically on evangelism, having evangelism workshops and institutes. The gospel can be presented recreationally through sports, sporting events, games, exercising, Zumba, Pilates, etc.
Yeah.
Doing ministry, this is our next section, means doing evangelism.
Yes, sir. Right.
Doing ministry means doing evangelism.
That's good, Scott.
Here's the key principle. Every form of legitimate ministry to be used as a form of evangelism.
Yes, sir.
Every form of legitimate ministry battle right. should be used right. as a form of evangelism.
Yes, sir.
All right, here we go. Ministry to the homeless should involve us evangelizing the homeless by sharing Jesus Christ.
Yes,
not just giving them, bread and food and meat, amen.
Yeah.
We need to be telling them about Jesus.
Jesus, man. Yes, sir.
Amen. Ministry to the homeless should involve us evangelizing the homeless by sharing Jesus Christ. Ministry to gangbangers should involve us evangelizing gangbangers by sharing Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Ministry to alcoholics should involve us evangelizing alcoholics by saving Jesus Christ.
Yes, sir.
Ministry to battered women should involve us evangelizing battered women by sharing Jesus Christ. Ministry to sex addicts should involve us evangelizing sex addicts by sharing Jesus Christ.
Yes,
ministry
sir.
To drug addicts should involve us evangelizing drug addicts by sharing Jesus Christ.
Yes,
all right.
Sir.
Ministry to gambling addicts should involve us evangelizing gambling addicts by sharing Jesus Christ. Ministry to abused children should involve us evangelizing abused children by sharing Jesus Christ.
Yes, sir.
The late Papa E.B. Hill, who was like a second father to me, would always use, listen now, his annual days for evangelistic purposes. Pastors, I know one fellow in Northern California who is so hard against having annual Sundays. He doesn't understand that they can be used for great evangelistic purposes.
Yes, sir.
That's what Father E.B. Hill did.
Yeah.
All right? For example, for Men's Day, he would challenge his men to bring as many unsaved men as possible to church on that day.
Wow.
For Women's Day, he would challenge his women to bring as many unsaved women as possible to church on that day.
Yes, sir.
For Youth Day, annual Youth Day, he would challenge his youth to bring as many unsaved young people as possible to church on that Day.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
Evangelism and technology. Now, this is where we are. Evangelism and technology. Two key principles to consider.
Talk, Doc.
Technology should never be used for technology's sake.
Wow. Wow.
Open that up.
Wow.
Just because other people doing this, doing that, you just doing it. Amen. With no rhyme or reason. No sense of what you're really doing. No. And then technology should only be used for the glory of God and for the furtherance of the gospel.
Oh my God.
Yeah. We cannot afford to be used by technology. We must use technology for the purposes of God's kingdom.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
All right.
That's good.
Ways in which, watch me now, technology can be a curse.
Yeah.
Talk, Doc. Talk.
It can be a blessing. Amen. We're doing a technological presentation today.
That's right.
That's a blessing, but it can be a curse.
Uh-huh.
How's that? When it consistently discourages actual physical worship.
Wow.
That's
my. Hebrews 25 says that we are not to forsake the assembling of ourselves.
Yes, sir.
Amen. 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 I just preached for Dr. R.A. Williams, third Sunday in December. Amen. He has never stopped meeting. He's going to have 80 to 100 folks right there. Okay. Now, everybody's following the protocols, taking the temperature, wearing masks, social distancing, all of that. But they're meeting. Say amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. Praise be to God.
Yeah.
All right. Let's move on. All right. Number two, technology can be a curse when it discourages, biblical literacy. Knowing your Bible.
My.
1 Peter 2 and 2 says, desire the sincere milk of the word.
Yes, sir.
So that he may grow thereby.
Yes, sir.
Technology can be a curse when it encourages pastor and people to become lazy in the things of God. Technology can be a curse when it decreases the attention span of believers to think on eternal matters.
Yes.
Colossians 3 and 2, set your affections on things above and not on things on the earth.
Wow. Yes,
technology, amen, can be a curse when it presents itself as a substitute for the spiritual disciplines of prayer, consecration, meditation, fasting, and spiritual digestion.
My God.
My God.
Yeah.
And then finally, technology can be a curse when it emphasizes making money more than making converts.
Yeah.
Dr. Wilson, amen. Dr. Lewis, Dr. Battle, my late great father used to say, amen, and I have a book that I did on him, it's on the table. He used to say that the problem with the contemporary church today is that it's paying more attention to the lost coin than it is to the lost sheep.
Oh, my. That's good.
Yes,
there.
Sir.
Paying more attention to the lost coin than it is to the lost sheep. All right. Various platforms and configurations that are being used during this pandemic season. Of course, Zoom, Facebook, live stream, etc. All combinations thereof. They got all kinds of platforms now.
Yeah.
Amen. Praise be to God. Some congregations physically meet limited numbers and do various platforms simultaneously.
Uh-huh.
Amen. We're doing that right now.
Right.
Amen. Some congregations record the sermon during the week and play it on Sunday. I've done many of those already. Yeah. Some congregations meet by having worship where?
Outside
with the people in their car.
Uh-huh.
Say amen.
Yeah.
Amen. My dear friend, amen, Dr. James Markham, Pastor of Emmanuel Temple, CME Church, Victorville, California. Amen. Preach for him every year for many, many years and during this pandemic season. And he has about, 50, 60 cars out there. And I'm preaching from the platform, from the patio. Amen. And they can't say amen, so they honk their horn.
Yeah.
That's the amen. That's the amen.
Amen.
All kinds of configurations are being witnessed today. All right, here we go. In doing virtual worship and evangelism, what should the body of Christ, pastors in particular, keep in mind?
Yes.
Number one, there are many people watching and listening who do not know Christ at all.
That's so true, God.
Have mercy.
We keep assuming that disbelievers are watching the broadcast. No, 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 no.
That's right.
Many people. Amen. They're searching during this pandemic season.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Amen.
Yes, sir.
Do not know Christ at all. We need to keep this in mind, all right? Watch me now. Incorporating testimonies from selected individuals can have a powerful effect.
Wow.
During this pandemic season.
That's good, Scott.
Young people.
That's good.
Millennials.
Yes.
Older people.
Uh-huh.
Just giving their testimony. Say amen, somebody.
Yeah.
In fact, if you could have an entire broadcast with just folks giving their testimony.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right. All right. The Bible, the Word of God, watch me now, should be read in different translations.
Ah.
The NIV, the Amplified Bible, New Living Translation, the Message Bible, etc. Amen. Concerning a particular scripture or a particular passage. Amen.
Yeah,
people can get a better understanding when those scriptures are being read in different translations.
Mm.
Amen. Now we're getting to the heart of it here.
All right.
Never forget to appreciate the Word of God as seed.
Talk, God. Talk.
Never forget to appreciate
the
Word of God as
seed. Yes, sir.
All right. Luke 8 and 11, amen. Jesus is getting ready to comment on the parable he's told, and he says, the seed is the Word of God.
Yes, yes.
This means that when we are teaching, preaching, and evangelizing virtually, please be ever so careful to know that we are planting seed.
Yes.
The seed of the Word of God.
Wow.
No wonder Dr. John R. Rice maintains that evangelism in whatever form is gospel seed planting.
Yes, sir.
My God. Furthermore, we should be wise and confident to know that our seed sowing, while in most cases, will not have instant results.
Uh-huh.
The harvest of souls is surely on the way.
That's a good word.
Say amen, somebody.
Amen.
Amen. Galatians 6 and 9, let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap.
Yes,
sir.
If we faint not.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah to the Lamb of the God, living God. Now, another important issue.
Uh-huh.
The Holy Spirit.
Wow.
Virtual worship and evangelism.
Talk, talk.
The Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Virtual worship and evangelism. Mm-hmm. Regardless of our various types of social media platforms, Zoom, Facebook, Livestream, etc., regardless of our in-person gatherings, if the Holy Spirit is not present and prominent in our worship, at best, we are just pathetically going through the motions.
Mm-hmm. Dr. Scott.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
If the Holy Spirit is not
prominent,
if the Holy Spirit is not prominent, we are pathetically just going through the motion.
Wow.
All right? Because if the Holy Spirit is not present, the Word of God will have great difficulty getting through the airwaves.
My.
If the Holy Spirit is not present, the unsaved remain lost and confused.
Yeah.
If the Holy Spirit is not present, no growth takes place among those who are looking and listening. If the Holy Spirit is not present, those who are tuning in are not inspired to live better for Christ.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
The big question. How can the Holy Spirit have an impact virtually?
Yes, sir.
Talk to us, Doc.
Huh? How can, the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, have an impact virtually?
Wow.
All right, here we go. Those who are preaching, teaching, and singing on a broadcast must themselves.
My God.
Themselves be filled with, controlled by the Holy Spirit.
Yes, my God, that's good, God.
They have to be filled and controlled by
the Holy Spirit. Turn the light on, man.
Pray to God. Ephesians 5 and 18, Paul says, and be not drunk with wine, wherein is excess, but be filled with the Spirit.
Yes,
that
Greek
word word used for the word fill in that verse literally means to be controlled by.
My God.
Whatever is Holy Spirit filled is Holy Spirit controlled.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Somebody missed that. I said, whatever is Holy Spirit filled is Holy Spirit controlled.
Control.
Now, here's a deeper insight. Here's a deeper insight. I want you to get it. Amen. Amen. Praise be to God. Paul is actually saying and profoundly suggesting that whatever you are full of controls you. Whatever you are full of controls you. You full of wine, then wine controls you. You full of liquor, then liquor controls you. You full of drugs, drugs controls you. You full of anger, anger controls you. You full of jealousy, jealousy controls you. You full of mesh, mesh controls you. Amen. You full of Prozac, Prozac controls you. You full of Ritalin, Ritalin controls you. Amen. BT, you full of Viagra. I'm sorry. But if you're full of the Holy Ghost, if you're full of the Holy Spirit, then the Holy Spirit controls.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Turn the light on. Turn the light on.
The Holy Spirit controls.
Yes, sir.
You. Secondly, consequently, those who are preaching, teaching, and singing must be ever so mindful that it is the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Not themselves who needs to be seen, promoted, and experienced.
That's good right there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Additionally, pastors should choose, watch this, pastor. Pastors should choose only those persons to lead the worship service who have proven that they have been indwelt by the Holy Spirit.
Right. I know you're right.
Three fruits of the Holy Spirit, I'm going a little bit deeper here. The three fruits of the Holy Spirit that must be seen in those who lead virtual worship. I picked out three of the nine, all right? Love, joy, and faith.
Wow.
They got to be seen by those who are presenting the gospel.
That's good.
Amen. Good. Virtually, all right? In Matthew 7 and 16, Jesus powerfully states, ye shall know them by their
fruits.
Yes, this takes on tremendous significance during our virtual atmosphere in which we're in. All right? Let's look at these three specific fruits. Love, that Greek word, of course, is agape.
Uh-huh.
The fruit of love, somebody help me say love.
Love.
Must be seen on the countenance.
My God.
Of those who lead worship.
My God.
You can't have anybody trying to participate in your broadcast. Say amen, somebody.
That's good, dog.
Amen. Who's angry?
Right.
Who's negative?
Right.
Who's hateful?
Right.
Who's bitter?
Right.
Who's resentful?
Right.
Oh, no, no, no.
Can't have it, brother.
Can't have it, pastors.
No, no.
You got to choose folk for love.
Yeah.
Next one is joy.
Yes.
That Greek word is chara. Somebody help me say joy.
Joy.
The fruit of joy should overwhelmingly be on the faces of those who lead virtual worship.
Yes, sir.
You need folk with joy on their faces.
Yes, sir.
They're happy to address the people.
Right.
Say amen, somebody.
Amen.
They're happy to be on God's program.
Yes.
Amen. The next fruit is faith.
Faith.
That Greek word is pistis. Somebody help me say faith.
Faith.
The fruit of faith, trust, and confidence should be heard in the voices.
Trust.
In the voices.
Yes.
Amen. Of those who lead virtual worship.
Yeah.
All right. Conclusively then, when the fruit of the Spirit, love, joy, and faith in particular, are abundantly observed in those who are leading virtual worship, the unsaved will be gripped and motivated.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to close out with this final issue dealing with prayer. The forgotten element has been prayer.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
One of the huge mistakes, Dr. Angelos, that many are making who lead in virtual worship is that they have seriously forgotten the essential element of prayer.
I believe it, God.
Yeah.
But if the body of Christ is not so careful, It will allow virtual worship to become prayerless worship.
Lord, yes. Wow.
It will allow virtual worship, Dr. Battle, to become prayerless worship.
Jesus.
1 Thessalonians says, 1 Thessalonians 5:17, pray without
ceasing.
Moreover, we run the risk of becoming so technological that we cease from being theological.
Wow.
With prayer suffering as a casualty.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Make no mistake. Prayerless worship, virtual or otherwise, will not have the capacity to release God's Holy Ghost power to evangelistically save anyone.
My God, my God.
Well, my brothers and sisters, this ends our lecture for today. I want to say thank you to Dr. Angelos Wilson.
Wow.
Amen.
Wonderful.
Praise be to God. Thank you for Dr. B.T. Lewis. Amen. Dr. Battle and those of you who were present physically, God be praised for you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Dr. Angelos, do we have question and answer period in this section, or what do you do?
We have one in the lunch that we're going to have here.
All
but
right.
If you'll take some time to really show the folks at home what resources they can buy, one more time, please.
Okay, all right, okay,
yeah,
very
so
good.
Much.
All right, all right. Again, if you have yet to receive our very important lecture, Vital Lessons from the Virus, What God is Saying to Us During This COVID-19 Crisis, be sure to get it. Amen. You can contact us by way of our website, www.emmanuelscottjr.org, or contact New Beginnings Church. Pastor Angelos will get in touch with me and let me know your desire. For those of you who are really serious about evangelism, be sure to pick up our evangelism package. It has two lectures of mine that I've been teaching all over the country, Church Evangelism According to Christ and Discipleship for the 21st Century. And then, in my humble estimation, amen, the best book written on personal soul winning, entitled The Golden Path to Successful Personal Soul Winning by Dr. John R. Rice. These materials are available. Be sure to get your copies. Thank you, Pastor Wilson.
Thank you. Thank you. Can we give the Lord some praise for Dr. Manuel Scott? Amen.
Amen. Amen.
What a beautiful, beautiful lecture today. I don't know about you, brothers, but my heart has been filled. Amen?
Amen.
To all of you who are watching on the Operation Good News page, the Angelos Biblical Institute page, the New Beginnings Community Baptist Church page, and all of the sister churches at the Baptist Pastors Conference page, thank you so very much. I'm going to ask if our president of our citywide conference, Dr. Lewis, will come in just a moment and give us the itinerary for Dr. Scott this weekend, where he will be. You will want to be logging on to hear him proclaim God's word. And then also what may be happening in the city for us, if you'll give us an update. I have a mic here for you, ready to go. Give us an update on what your heart's desire would be for the African American Caucus, so we can know what's happening there. On behalf of Pastor Lawrence Chisholm and the Baptist Pastors Conference, we want to invite you on tomorrow night, if the Lord delays his coming, to join us at 6 p.m. right on the Baptist Pastors Conference page. We will be here where Dr. Scott will be preaching our very first worship gathering together as the men of God. 6 o'clock right here, Baptist Pastors Conference page, Facebook Live. We would love to have you here. I'm going to introduce now our beloved brother and leader, Pastor B.T. Lewis, who will give final words and then prayer over this time. Let's give him a hand as he comes.
Greetings to everyone. God bless you. It is our pleasure to be here on this day with Dr. Wilson and the New Beginnings Church, and to also be a part of this evangelism project that he has presented to our community. Amen. And so we're excited to be part of that. And we want to encourage you to also join us in this effort to reach the lost in our community. Amen. It is important. Pastor Wilson actually brought it to our attention as we contemplated all of the struggles that we're facing in our community, gun violence, a rising crime in general, people that are struggling with the fallout of the pandemic and all that burdens our families with. And he reminded us that we do have the ultimate answer to all of these problems, and that answer is Jesus.
Amen.
And so this effort of evangelism that we are engaged in our city is designed to not only feed people, not only to bring the physical comforts that people may need in their lives, the relief that they may need financially, but our goal is to introduce them to a Savior that can supply all of their needs. We're trying to bring living water into the lives of the people of our city.
Yes.
The physical wells are running dry,
yes,
and they are finding it difficult to draw water from their wells.
Talk,
but we have the answer,
yeah,
in living water.
Yes, sir.
Amen. And every person in this city, every person in this county,
yeah,
every person in this region can find a source of relief and joy in the living water of,
yes,
Jesus.
Sir. Yes,
amen.
Sir.
And so we're part of a collaboration, the African American Clergy Caucus. And one of the things that we are collaborating with, we're collaborating with others in our community,
uh-huh,
to try to bring COVID relief to our families.
Yeah.
And so if you are struggling, if you have tested positive for COVID-19 and you know families that are struggling with resources, we have a source of relief.
Yeah.
For you that we would like to connect you with. We are also working on continuing to encourage the people in our community to get tested for COVID-19.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And to just know without a shadow of a doubt your status in regard to the virus. The,
yeah,
virus is not,
yeah,
only still very real, but now we are dealing with different variations of the virus.
Yes,
amen.
Sir.
And
yes,
so we,
sir,
have to do everything,
right,
that we can,
right,
to protect our families, and protect our children. Where I go and who I interact with does not only affect me,
no,
but it affects the people that I care for and the people that I live with in particular.
Yes,
and,
sir,
so be diligent, be diligent. Be careful to use the resources that God has given us to battle this element of sin.
Amen.
Make no mistake, disease is sin.
Right.
It is the evolution of sin.
Yeah.
Sin,
yeah.
Disease is the evolution. COVID-19 is the evolution of
sin
in the world.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
And the only thing, and God has given us,
uh-huh,
medical technology and medical science,
right,
to battle this element,
yeah,
of sin.
Yeah.
Amen. And so just, you know, make your own decisions, but make sure you make your decisions about taking the vaccine,
uh-huh,
when you'll take the vaccine,
yeah,
whether or not, make sure you make those decisions based on much prayer and much knowledge.
Very good, God.
Amen. Much prayer and much knowledge. And so we are encouraging our churches to invite in medical professionals, research professionals. We'll have one at our church on Tuesday evening on Zoom in our Bible study meeting. But we want to encourage pastors to help our people to become informed about the vaccine.
Yes,
amen.
Sir.
Amen. We want to be protected. We don't want our people left behind.
No,
in
sir,
fact,
that's right,
there is a new project getting underway now in Southwest Fresno at Gaston Middle School,
uh-huh,
that will make available the vaccine for people in our community.
Wonderful.
And so you'll be hearing more about that in the near future. And so we want to encourage you, in particular, our African American and Latino communities.
Yes, sir.
Amen. We want you in particular to make sure that you take care of your families and take,
yes,
care of yourselves. Amen. Get tested Amen. We'll have a testing at Rising Star on next Saturday, February 6th, from 9 to 1. Amen. You don't have to register. It is a drive-through COVID-19 testing. Amen, because testing is still important. Amen. And so we're just grateful for this opportunity to share with you what a wonderful lecture we heard today.
Yes.
Amen. 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 Doing evangelism in the age of COVID-19.
Yes,
because I don't care what they told you, the church is not dead.
It's not dead.
I don't care what they said. Amen. They said it because they just don't know Jesus.
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. The church is still the most essential element in your life.
Yes, sir.
There's nothing else in your life that can connect this life to your eternity in a positive way.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Amen. So the church and the gospel are the most important message that you and your children will ever hear. Amen. So it is important to continue to evangelize and disciple. Amen. Our families, our children, and our neighbors. It is important to continue to proclaim the gospel of Christ. Amen. Even though we may have to change some of our methods, we will never change our message. God bless you and thank you for this time. We are certainly grateful to Dr. Wilson for the great work that he's leading us in here in the city and region of Fresno County.
Amen.
So let me pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, God, for this time together. God, we have been blessed by the presence of your abiding Holy Spirit. God, how excellent is your name. God, we just love you for everything that you have done today.
Oh, yes.
God, you have planted seeds of hope and strategy in our hearts and in our minds. You have given us, God, a new lease on evangelism. And God, we really believe that the answer to every problem that we're facing, the answer, God, to the problems of racial and political unrest in our country, God, we believe that the answer to violence in the streets and homes of our city, we believe that the answer is still the blood of Jesus. And so, God, the best gift that you ever gave humanity was the gift of your Son. And so, God, we thank you again, God, for Jesus who died for us on Calvary's Hill, who shed blood, God, and then rose again on the third day with all power in heaven and in earth. God, we thank you for our salvation, and we thank you, God, for our expectation of eternal life with you. So, God, bless the word that has gone out today. Let it resonate in the hearts and minds of your people. Let those that had not heard it before, God, hear it clearly for the first time and come to salvation. God, the hope of our world is in salvation. The hope of our nation is in salvation. The hope of our families, the hope of our lives is in salvation. And salvation only comes through you. And so, God, hear our prayer on today. God, we pray for the salvation of the lost, the deliverance of those that are in bondage. In Jesus' name, be our strength, be our reference, and be your refuge, be our hiding place. And God, let us always remember that you are real, you are relevant, and God, that you are required. In Jesus' name we pray.
Name.
And the church said, hallelujah, wherever you are.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.